Thank you for introduction. So first of all, I'd like to thank organizer for giving me an opportunity to have a talk here. So I'd like to talk about the anti-self-dual Yamil equation in non-commutative spaces and the solutions in the ADHM procedure. So this sounds very maniac and complicated, but please be easy. So detail is not important. I just want to say how interesting non-commutative extension is and ADHM construction is. So this is based on the collaboration with Toshio Nakatsu-san in Setsuna University. And finally, I also mentioned the results of local solutions. This is based on collaboration with Gilson and Nimo-san in Glasgow. Okay, so let me introduce the motivation. So non-commutative spaces are defined, the non-commutativity of the spatial coordinates as follows. So where the constant in right-hand side is called the non-commutative parameter, and in my talk, this is a real constant, which just corresponds to the constant background magnetic field in physics. So this is not crazy. So let's discuss some properties very naively from the definition. So this relation looks like the canonical commutation relations in quantum mechanics. So very naively, this relation leads to the space-space uncertainty relation. So we cannot determine all the coordinates or the position of the particle. So very naively, the configuration becomes wave packet-like. This is, of course, very, very naive, but resolution of singularity is a very interesting property in non-commutative spaces. And the singularity which exists on commutative spaces becomes resolved. And as a concept, the new physical object appears. So this is also true in the context of instantons. So here, a small instanton singularity in the instanton modular space is resolved, and the new physical object, U1 instanton, appears. So later, we discuss in detail. OK, so this is our main equation. This is the standard anti-self-dual Yamil equation. So this is just a self-duality of the field strength in the sense of Hodge dual. OK, so let's start with this, the commutative theory, and move to non-commutative situation. I forget to. In my talk, gate group is UN. Okay, so move to the non-commutative spaces from this commutative equation. The procedure is very simple in the Moyal product formalism. We have just only to make a spell that all products of fields must be replaced with Moyal products. So in this equation, there is a product of field here. So this product is replaced with Moyal product. The product is defined as follows. So this looks very, very complicated, but the detail is not important. So this is just a picture. So please be easy. But I just comment that there is an exponential part here, and non-commutative parameter and derivative is included here. So we can expand this exponential as follows. So zeroth order of theta is usual commutative product. And first order just corresponds to the Poisson bracket. So we note that in this formalism, the coordinates and functions themselves are C number valued as usual. But because of the replacement of the product, we have a deformed equation here. And under this replacement, we can also calculate the commutator of the coordinate. This becomes non-trivial. So calculation is easily done by the definition. And we can easily find the results just give us the definition of the non-commutative spaces. So we can actually get the deformed equation on non-commutative spaces. And the equation is deformed, so solution is deformed. And the solution can be expanded as follows with respect to theta, as follows. So this is the context of deformation quantization. And this deformation means the background constant magnetic field in physics. Okay, so let's discuss the celebrated ADHM construction of instanton. This is actually very, very powerful to construct the exact instanton solutions. And based on very beautiful duality between the moduli space of instantons and the moduli space of some matrix equation, which is called the ADHM equation. This is actually one-to-one. So this is a mathematical result. So in my talk, gauge group is UN, and we fix the instanton number equal K. Then dual site, the rank of gauge group becomes K. So in some sense, the rank of gauge group and the instanton number is exchanged. So in original site, the equation is N by N partial differential equation with matrix values. So this is almost impossible to solve. But on the other hand, this is just a matrix equation, K by K matrix equation, so much easier to solve. And in order to prove the one-to-one correspondence, we have to define the duality map F and the inverse duality map G, and composite of F and G equal identity, and G and F is identity. So we've done in non-commutative settings. So this is the main result. Okay, so before, so now I will review the exact construction. And before that, I would like to comment here. In fact, this is a commutative ADHM equation. And in non-commutative situation, the commutator of spatial coordinate appears because Z and B always appears in pairs. So the existence of commutator of the B implies the existence of commutator of spatial coordinate. So in commutative spaces, right-hand side is of course zero, but in non-commutative situation, this becomes non-zero in general. So this point is important. Okay, let's construct the typical example of BPSD instantons in this procedure. So this is n equal 2 and k equal 1 case. Actually, ADHM equation is perfectly trivially solved because ADHM equation is just a k by k matrix equation. Now k equal 1, so this is scalar equation. So this commutator part automatically drop out. So we can set the 1 by 1 matrix B as arbitrary complex number. And the remaining term is also easily solved. I and J is N by K matrices, and the solution is this one. Rho is a real parameter. And this actually solves it, because the first equation sets I dagger equal rho square, and J dagger J is rho square and cancel out. The second equation sets the inner product of I and J equals 0. So actually, this is a general solution. And secondly, we have to solve that duality map. This is also, in fact, matrix equation. So good high school students easily solve this one also within 10 minutes calculation, I hope. Then we can get perfectly non-trivial configuration here. So this is a famous BPSD instanton solution. And this is actually instantons and localized in four-dimensional spaces as follows. Then we can easily see the meaning of the parameter. So alpha just corresponds to the position of the instanton, and rho just corresponds to the size of instanton. In fact, the diagonal element of B just corresponds to the position of the instanton, and I and J imply the information of the size. This point is also important in non-commutative settings, so please remember. And finally, I would like to comment on the rho zero limit. We can easily find the size zero limit, this configuration becomes the singular. So this just corresponds to the existence of the singularity in the instanton moduli spaces. So this is also easily understood from the ADHM side. So rho equals non-zero, the gauge group action, dual gauge group action is non-trivial. But in rho zero case, both I and J become zero. So then gauge group action becomes trivial. So have a fixed point. So the quotient space have the orbifold singularity. So this is a story of the commutative spaces. So now let's move to the non-commutative spaces. Then situation drastically changed. As I commented, the ADHD mutation have the commutator of the coordinate. Then non-zero constant appears here, which comes from the non-commutative of the spaces. Then the solution is deformed due to this constant zeta. So this is actually the general solution because II dagger becomes rho square plus zeta now. But please remember that the I and J imply the information of the size. So naively, we expect the instanton becomes fat by zeta. So this is actually true. And even in rho zero limit, this is still regular. And actually, dissolution of singularity occurs. Because even in rho zero limit, I is still non-zero. So dual gauge group action is still regular. So orbifold quotient space have no singularity. So, and which comes from the non-commutativity of the spatial coordinate. So in this sense, non-commutative situation is natural, and ADHM construction works well, of course. And this rho zero limit actually corresponds to the U1 instanton. Okay, so now let's discuss the instanton number. Actually, many people show this instanton number just corresponds to the size of ADHM data. Okay. But the calculation is done one by one. So there is no general proof. So we prove this generally. So now let's discuss the proof of the one-to-one correspondence between instanton moduli space and the dual ADHM moduli space in non-commutative settings. So the way of proof of one-to-one is just one. So we define dual map and inverse dual map, and the composite is identity, and the inverse composite is also identity. So the previous review is from ADHM to instanton side. So this is a standard ADHM construction. And we discuss anti-duality only, but here we discuss also the instanton number comes from the size of ADHM. And we prove the following non-commutative version of Atia-Foley formula. So this looks very, very complicated. So, but please be easy. This is detail is not important. So this is just a picture. But I would like to comment. So ADHM construction have the geometrical meaning of a vector bundle. So first, we set the higher rank trivial vector bundle and decompose into rank n part and rank 2k part. And the rank n part just corresponds to the instanton. And the dual rank 2k part just corresponds to the ADHM part. But originally, trivial vector bundle exists. So this formula says this is the instanton number of the rank n part. And this is the instanton number of the rank 2k part. The totally that zero due to the Chan Bayh theory. And this is just a deformed formula. And this is also true in non-commutative situations. And by using this formula, we can easily calculate the instanton number. And the dual side, this contains the information of the ADHM data only. So we can directly show the size of instanton, this k comes from this k and gives the instanton number equals zero. So we prove the important aspects of ADHM construction. Furthermore, we have to discuss the inverse construction from instanton to ADHM. Then we have to solve this time four-dimensional Dirac equation as follows. This might be very difficult. But Midas Sacco recently proved the existence of this four-dimensional Dirac zero mode by a formal power expansion of non-commutative parameter. So they expand and put into the Dirac equation And this A is a background instanton configuration, which is given. And this psi is unknown. And they found the explicit formula of psi 0 and psi 1, psi 2 explicitly, recursively, one by one. So we apply their idea to all whole of radiation construction, and we continue to prove the composite of its identity from ADHM to instanton and returning back to ADHM. Then this is the identity we proved. And finally, we also prove that from instanton to ADHM to instanton is also identity. So in this context, this Maeda-Sakoda idea is crucial, and we succeed in proving the existence of something. The boundary condition would be subtle, but we solve the problem. So we prove the ADHM duality in formal power series of theta expansion in non-commutative station. Okay, so there is no time, so I just conclude and discuss the new motivation why non-commutative extension is interesting. So now we discuss the global solution, instantons. Then non-commutativity leads to the resolution of singularity. So in this sense, it is more natural than commutative one. And in fact, for local solutions, non-commutative version of determinant, the quasi-determinant, play crucial roles, in fact. So I just show the results only. So this is a non-commutative Young equation, which is actually equivalent to the non-commutative anti-self-related Young-Mills. So this is not types of CN Young, but the non-commutative CN Young equation. This solution is given in terms of quasi-determinant in such a very, very compact form, much more than expected. So this is very, very surprising, and the proof is much, much easier than commutative one. So non-commutative settings seems to be much easier than commutative one. This sounds strange. So how should we interpret this one? Now, I think so it is best formulation that can be expanded to non-commutative situation. So I mean, commutative situation might be so special that various formulation could be possible. So non-commutative extension would be worth studying, I think. Okay, thank you very much. Yeah, I'm sorry.
First of all, is there a good reason why you will consider anti-self dual configurations?
Yeah.
And the second question is, if you do a power series expansion of your non-commutative effects, in that it's a recursive prescription to generate the higher coefficients.
Yeah, yeah.
How can we, you know, by truncating the zero, which we have to do eventually, resolve the singularities that you promised to be resolved? So the road equals zero limit, so to speak. I cannot see that in a finite truncation of your power series.
Finite truncation, I don't discuss. And the first question would be.
First question is simple. Why anti-self-dual?
Not self-dual, you mean. That's equivalent by flipping the one special coordinate. So not important. Anti. Self-dual instanton is also possible. All the same, yeah. And the second question, it needs more time, so please discuss later. Yeah.